Hello my friends of Hatari Labs, my name is Saul Montoya. Welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial we are going to review actually there was a tutorial that I did 6 years ago, 5 years ago, about how to do a Winrose with Python. Well, actually I did it in Spanish, so it was a good time to translate it to English. Okay, so you are going to in the description of the video, what you are going to find is the zipped version of this folder, where you are going to find some Excel file with rows win data, okay, and a script, okay, and the script we are going to clear our outputs, okay. So first, what we are going to do is we are going to import the required pa package, okay. So pandas, NumPy, matplotlib. Yeah, and then we are going, in case that you don't have this, in case that you don't have this package of Winrose and OpenPy Excel, you can, but just running this one time, you can install it. Okay, I have already, and then you are going to import Winrose as Winrose Access. Okay, that is a very practical library, but not so popular, but very practical. Okay, so we are going to open the data from Excel file, and then we have the ID of the station, the speed, the direction, and the direction on degrees. Okay, and then we do two representations. First, we are going to represent the wind and with the wind on the X direction and the wind on the Y direction, and they see that this really we see no trends here. Then we are going to represent the histogram of the wind speed. Okay, so this is histogram. Actually, there are not so many values in order to create a Gaussian or log normal bell. Okay, but yep, yeah. Okay, with a larger data set, that can work better also. Okay, so we can plot the wind bar with the Winrose in bar mode, and so by taking the direction and the velocity and the speed, we can do this. Okay, so where this is a representation on the wind speed with direction, no? Okay. So, and then we can plot a Winrose in a proportional box mode. So plotting the average count of measurements. So and say, okay, because we have few measurements of low speed and high measurements of higher speed. So that's why. We can plot the Winrose as a field mode on contours. Yeah, but these are as a polygons and these are as a contours. Okay, so this was the tutorial. All the scripts you are going to define in the description of the video, and I strongly recommend to use or to review the website of the package, because if you want more information, you can go to the website of the package and then see what else and any other definition. Okay, my plan is also to do a geospatial representation of the Winrose, that it will be quite interesting. I mean, to see the Winrose, but as an attribute of the Winrose as an attribute of a pipe of a shape file, of a point shape file. Okay, well, thank you for following us. Thank you for following our YouTube channel or whatever channel. Thank you for sharing our blog with your friends. Hope to see you in coming tutorials and have a great day. Bye bye. Bye.